The Google Pixel 4 is finally here and Google invited me to the office in Berlin to check out the brand new Pixel 4 and Pixel 4 XL. And here are my first and honest impressions. The Google Pixel 4 arrives alongside with its bigger brother, the Google Pixel 4 XL, and offers some new flagship photography features based on massive machine learning and AI. It's a successor to the Google Pixel 3, but the upgrades are kinda small. Google hasn't really pushed the boundaries in terms of hardware, but on the software side, holy cow, this phone is crazy. The key highlights for the Pixel 4 are dual rear cameras, which include now a telephoto lens as well as some software-based upgrades. And then you also get new motion sense gesture controls, face unlock, a faster Google Assistant, and plenty of smart software features, including a recording app that can transcribe your voice recordings in real time, and this works incredibly good. We tested it at the event where it was really loud, and as you can see here, it's working really, really fine. The Pixel 4 and the Pixel 4 XL are priced the same as the Pixel 3 series last year. The 5.7-inch Pixel 4 is starting at around $800 for only 64GB of storage, and the larger 6.3-inch Pixel 4 XL at roughly $900. You can upgrade the storage to 128GB for another 100 bucks. Both the Pixel 4 and the Pixel 4 XL come with dual cameras on the back, and this is Google's first multi-lens rear imaging system ever, including a primary 12-megapixel sensor with a 16-megapixel telephoto shooter for 2x optical zoom. Google has also implemented its so-called SuperRes zoom technology. You will be able to crop in 10 times without losing as much detail as with digital zoom, so basically what other manufacturers call a hybrid zoom. On the front it features an 8-megapixel selfie snapper with f2.0 and 90 degrees field of view, so it's nice wide angle. When you have already used the Pixel phone, you will notice that it takes a few seconds after you take the pics to see a final result because Google does some crazy software editing and sharpens the pictures, raises the shadows, and yeah, just basically makes it look fine out of the box. So if you hate editing pictures, it's really great, and my camera review will come very soon, stay tuned. Google has finally taken the camera game to the next level as well, but not so much on the hardware side. The new features include machine learning based white balancing, as well as a new live HDR Plus feature which presents the optimized final results in the viewfinder before you press the shutter button. Also, the very popular night sight mode should have been improved. Dual exposure controls let you tweak the brightness and shadows in real time via sliders on the display, and also it comes with an improved portrait mode for taking even more realistic portraits. My review will come online next week, but so far I can say I love the sliders for adjusting the brightness and shadows, as this gets you really an idea of how you could make the picture look in post, or if you don't want to edit, just take the picture as it is. While there are some really cool software tricks to improve the pictures, I'm just a bit sad that it doesn't include a wide-angle camera or 4K 60 video recording. Anyhow, Google said that a telephoto lens is way more important than a wide-angle lens, but for me as a video maker, I have to disagree. I would have really loved to see it on the phone. The Pixel 4 can read hand gestures in mid-air using the phone's new Soli radar chip, and it allows you to navigate some elements of the interface without physically touching the device. I've only had a short hands-on time with Motion Sense, but it feels like the best integration I've seen so far. I tried LG's attempt on the G8S, and to be honest, it was really bad, but on the Pixel, the phone even detects your movement 30cm away from the phone, and also detects false positive movements like just putting a cup of coffee over your phone, which is really smart. You can use it for switching tracks in the music app, which work really great, and I can't wait what other software implementations Google will make with the sensor. And also there was a funny Pokemon app where you could interact with the phone using the motion sensor, so really cool stuff. But yeah, right now there are not too many other features than skipping songs and silencing alarms, because they're not implemented yet, but there is more to come. The Pixel 4 comes with a Full HD Plus OLED panel and the Pixel 4 XL with a Quad HD Plus one. Both feature 90Hz refresh rate for super smooth animations and scrolling. The refresh rate also scales dynamically, depending on what's on the screen, so you can save battery. Now 90Hz is absolutely the future. I was really stunned when I tested this on the OnePlus 7 Pro and the OnePlus 7T this year with the 90Hz screen, because scrolling and faster moving objects just look amazingly smooth. You really need to check this out in reality. Now regarding the design, I would say the Pixel 4 is way less ugly than the Pixel 3. The second speaker is now at the bottom next to the USB-C port, and the Pixel 4 XL loses the Pixel 3 XL's strange notch, so both models look identical, but just differ in size. Google has also released three colors that look very minimalistic but really stylish. We have clearly white, just black, and oh so orange. But the orange one will be a limited edition in most of the countries. Also, it packs wireless charging and it's IP68 waterproof. The Pixel 4 has a 2800 mAh battery, that's 115 mAh less than the last generation, while the Pixel 4 XL has a 3700 mAh battery, which is 270 mAh more than the last generation. So those 90Hz displays are known to be pretty hard on battery life. So I'm doing a battery comparison on the weekend with the Mate 30 Pro and the Sony Xperia 5, so stay tuned for that. But you really need to know that 90Hz screens really drain your battery fast, and this all now comes down to the software optimization of the dynamic upscaling. Performance-wise, it packs the Qualcomm's latest flagship, the Snapdragon 855 chipset, with an increased RAM to 6GB, bringing the phone more in line with the Android competition, although it's still pretty low for a costly flagship. But the software optimization is just great and it runs perfectly smooth. It's running Android 10 and comes with all Google services ready to use. I use Google Pay a lot with Boon by Wirecard, which allows you to have a prepaid MasterCard which you can top up by using a Visa, MasterCard or just bank transfer. On this phone it works like a charm, and it's also really secure because when you use Boon with Google Pay, you need to do a biometric safety check. But where is the fingerprint scanner for it? Well, they dropped it. If you currently use your fingerprint to sign in into Android apps, you will find your biometric login options are a little bit limited on the Pixel 4. But Google says it will work with app developers to bring in face unlock for logins. For paying it's really fine, but for other apps this will take some time. Anyhow, the face unlock is really the fastest one and most accurate one I've seen so far on an Android phone. Now the Google Assistant has been improved in Android 10 with the Pixel 4. You can now request it to open apps and perform also searches in them, which is really cool and saves time. And also there's a new way to activate the Assistant too, so just swipe up from the bottom corner of the screen. Alternatively, you can still use the wake up word "Hey Google" and the squeezable sides of the Pixel 4 as you can do on the last generation, but if you don't want to use it, Google now allows you to completely shut it off. All in all, the Pixel 4 isn't maybe the most interesting piece of hardware, but the company shows that you can get stunning results out of common hardware by just getting the software right. Motion sense, three-dimensional face unlock, and the faster refresh rate display are really useful new features that differentiate the newest Pixels from their competitors on the market. And I can't wait to drop the full review on the 21st, so stay tuned. So big thanks for watching this review, and as always guys, I'm Steven from Tech Magnet, and I will catch you in the next one. Have a nice day and bye!